Statistics Chapter Section 1, Measures of Central Tendencies. Statistics is the process of attempting to organize and understand raw, unorganized information or data. We will concentrate on descriptive statistics. This type of statistics is concerned with giving us information about what is, as opposed to predicting what will happen. Our goals are to learn some terminology used in basic statistics, understand the purpose, and learn how to compute and use basic statistical measures. The definition for the measure of central tendency is that it is a number that best describes a group of data. Here we have an example of test scores from a blueprint reading class. And this single number, an overall average of 79%, is a measure of central tendency, a single number representing a group of data. There are three types of central tendencies that we will calculate in this section. They are the mean, median, and mode. If our data is very similar, these values could be very close to one another. But if our data is skewed, where a bulk of the values are in one area with some numbers not similar to the rest, then we may find that there is a difference between the mean, median, and mode. Here we have a survey of 15 students and the distance that they drive from home to Southwest Tech. A lot of numbers, we'd like a single number to represent that. So with the first example, we'll determine the mean for this. And to compute the mean, which is represented with X bar, we will take the sum of the data divided by N. Here, N is the quantity of data that we're working with, and of course, sum is the total for the data. So back to our commuting distance survey, we will add up all of the 15 commute distances and divide it by the number of numbers to give us the mean, or X bar. So our sum is 374.7. There are 15 students, and when you divide, we end up with a mean of 25 miles. This mean is a measure of central tendency. It's a single value to represent the entire group, and it's an attempt to show the middle of this data. On page 2 in your textbook, you should find some additional practice computing the mean. Here we have values of 8 homes listed for this subdivision. They're asking us, what is the mean home value? So we will add up all of those house values and divide by 8, since there are 8 homes. The mean value for this group of home prices is $164,375. But if you look at the values, all of them are very similar, relatively speaking, with one exception. 380 is more than double the highest priced house here. In the statistical world, when we have values that are extremely large or extremely smaller than the rest of the data, we have what's called an outlier. So the mean isn't always the best measure of central tendencies when this is the case. Instead, we would turn to the median. And in the median, you may have heard this term before. It's the area between two lanes of traffic, and the median here isn't that far off in the mathematical world from the median or the middle of the highways. It's the middle of an ordered set of numbers. So to find the median for a group of data, as we have here, the first thing will be to put the data in order from the highest to the lowest, or the lowest to the highest. Sometimes it's referred to as ranked data. Next, we want to find the middle number. And since there's 7 numbers, we have 3 below and 3 above. 75 is the median for this set of data. In the event you have an even number of data values. The procedures are basically the same to start with. We need to put them in numerical order, determine where the middle is. Because there's an even number, the middle is falling in between two numbers. There's three below and three above this middle when they're in numerical order. And to determine the median, you will average those two numbers on either side of the middle, and that result will be the median. So 77.5 is the median. Even though it isn't an actual number in this group, it is the correct representation for the median. The median is a better measure of central tendency for this example because it tends to tune out extremely large or extremely small values. In this case, when we put these values in numerical order and we're looking for the median, since there's 8, our median will be the average of the numbers on either side of the middle. So here we're only going to average the 135,000 and 140,000 by adding them and dividing by 2. The median, which is a truer measure of central tendency and representative of most of the houses, is 137,500, where if you remember, the mean was over $163,000. It was pulled or skewed higher because of this extremely large value. The median tunes out those extreme outlier values, whether they're small or larger than the rest of the data. Back to our survey of commuting distance. First, if we were after the median, we would need to put these numbers in numerical order. We have 7 values below the middle, 7 values above the middle, and there's the middle, or the median value of 29. For additional practice on median calculations, turn to page 5. The third measure of central tendency is the mode. This is used when you want to know which data appears the most frequently, if any. And an illustration of this might be a vending machine. If this vending machine had been completely filled, and now you've walked past after some time, the blinking light means that this flavor of soda is sold out. This means that this was the most popular or the most frequently occurring choice. It would be the mode, the most common or popular. Back to the survey of commute distances, we're looking for the number that occurs the most common or most popular. 30 is here, and so the mode for this set of data is 30. In practical settings, the mode is used to find out what is most common or popular. A retail store might want to know what style or size of shirt is the most popular, so they will know what to order the next time they have to restock. A car parts store might want to know which brand of rebuild kits and which engine size is most popular, so they will always have enough in stock as well. Practice on computing mode can be found on page 7, and review of all three measures of central tendencies on page 11.